All right, hopefully, again, sorry, we can't hear me, just maybe we're experiencing technical difficulties, just checking. Let us know in the group chat or just text me if you can hopefully hear me now. Thanks. Hello, welcome to the Vanbrugh virtual quiz. Hopefully we've got over the technical issues. It wouldn't be a sort of video quiz if there weren't technical difficulties. Sorry about that, so hopefully that's all sorted now. But if it isn't, let me know in the comments and we'll look into it. But yeah, we've just been playing around with the mic, etc., because we had problems last week. So apologies for that. Right. I'm Jay, which you'll all know already by now, but welcome to the Vanbrugh virtual quiz. Same format as usual. We're going to have four rounds, then we'll have a brief break and I'll give you the answers to the first few rounds. We'll then crack on with the second half of the quiz. The first half of the quiz, as usual, is going to be made up of four rounds of five questions. The first four rounds are current affairs as usual. Second round is MA, which I'll explain to you. Third round, food and drink. And round four, I've actually got a movie clip round for you this week. So, as I said, trying to be a bit more tech savvy with the quiz. Anyway, so as usual, if there's any issues with the speed or just with the audio and you need anything repeating, just let me know in the comments. Let me know who's playing and what you're drinking. I'm keeping it light with some Heineken Zero, but I may switch that out later after all the issues we've had with the audio. But as I said, starting with round one, current affairs. So hopefully you've been watching the news from last week. So question one, UK lorry drivers at the Dutch border recently expressed surprise when what items from their lunchboxes were confiscated at the Dutch border? So British lorry drivers had what items confiscated from their lunchboxes at the Dutch border? Hi Liam, good to have you on board again. Hi John. Question two. Hi Diane, John and Louis. Question two. Which British model has been appointed as Kenya's tourism ambassador? Hi Amber, hi Adrian. Hi Alicia, good to have you back. Nice bit of red there, Diane. So question two was, which British model has been appointed as Kenya's tourism ambassador? Hi Matt, good to have you back. Question three, which reality TV star made his debut for League Two team Crawley Town in the closing minutes of their FA Cup victory over Leeds United? On the run, yeah, good work. Question three, which reality TV star made his debut for League Two team Crawley Town in the closing minutes of their FA Cup victory over Leeds? Hi Claire. Hi Jeff and kids, good to have you along. Question four. Which ITV drama centres around Steve Wilkins, who in 2006 reopened two unsolved double murders from the 1980s. So I want the name of the show here. Which ITV drama centres around Steve Wilkins, who in 2006 reopened two unsolved double murders from the 1980s? And nice easy one to finish off round one. Which building was stormed by a crowd on the 6th of January 2021? Which building was stormed by a crowd on 6th of January 2021? I'm actually a lot for round one, so please let me know if you need anything repeated. And I'll hold on before I crack on with round two and explain that, and pause for some repeats of any questions from round one. Right, looks like everyone's okay, but as always, if you do need anything repeated, just jump in on the chat. Round two is MA, so we've had some of these rounds before. So every answer has the letters MA in that order in the answer. So hopefully that makes sense. So the letters M and A will appear in that order together in the answer to the question. So question one. From which ore is iron obtained? From which ore is iron obtained? Diane, questions two and three. Sorry, I'm going to jump back to round one. Question two was, which British model has been appointed as Kenya's tourism ambassador? Which British model has been appointed as Kenya's tourism ambassador? And three was, which reality TV star made his debut for League Two Crawley Town in the last minutes of their famous FA Cup victory over Leeds United? So it's the name of the reality TV star. Round two, as I said, it's MA, so I'm looking for the letters MA in that order as a hint to every answer in this round. So question one again was, from which ore is iron obtained? From which ore is iron obtained? Question two, how are the members of the Grand Lodge of All England more commonly known? How are the members of the Grand Lodge of All England more commonly known? Liam, we can't put down the wizards, as we used to call them when we worked together. Two, how are the members of the Grand Lodge of All England more commonly known? Three, which boxer did Muhammad Ali beat in the fight billed as the Rumble in the Jungle? So who did Muhammad Ali beat in the Rumble in the Jungle? Question four, the song Up Where We Belong was the theme from which Richard Gere film? The song Up Where We Belong is the theme from which Richard Gere film? And finally, which cartoonist was the creator of the TV series The Simpsons? Which cartoonist was the creator of the TV series The Simpsons? That's your lot for round two. So let me know if you need anything repeated. Otherwise, we'll move on to round three, which is all about food and drink. There's a little treat for you in the second half, as we no longer hopefully have to deal with Mr. Trump anymore. There is a special round dedicated to him later in the quiz. Three and four, Jonathan. Three was, which boxer did Muhammad Ali beat in the Rumble in the Jungle? So I want the name of the other fighter. And four, the song Up Where We Belong was the theme from which Richard Gere film? Hi, Charlie. I'm guessing you may need a few questions repeated. Yeah, Charlie, I'll repeat that at half time, as it were. So I'll do a quick run through after I've done round three and four. Oh, actually before round four, because round four is a video for you all to watch. So let's go on to round three. So it's all to do with food and drink. In the UK, it's known as bubble and squeak, but what is its equivalent known as in Ireland? So what is bubble and squeak known as in Ireland? Two, what sea is a South American dish of marinated raw fish? What sea is a South American dish of marinated raw fish? Tom, that'd be your idea of food heaven, wouldn't it? Three, multiple choice here. Which best describes a chicken Maryland? Is it A, chicken served in a sweet maple syrup sauce? B, chicken in a warm fruit cocktail? Or C, fried chicken served chilled? So what best describes chicken Maryland? Is it A, chicken served in a sweet maple syrup sauce? B, chicken in a warm fruit cocktail? Or C, fried chicken served chilled. Question four. Lincolnshire sausages are flavoured with which herb? So Lincolnshire sausages are flavoured with which herb? Dolly, I don't know if you're playing. I haven't seen you say hello, but if you are, that one's for you. Just to say, Charlie, to make it easier, rather than me going through them, the questions to rounds one and two are going to be posted in the chat shortly, so you'll be able to see them there. So, final question for in round three, question five. In which country is the winemaking region of Yarra Valley? So where would you find the winemaking region of Yarra Valley? And that's your lot for round three. Let me know if you need any of those repeated. I'll just tee you up for round four as well, because I won't be posing the questions. What you're going to see is a series of five clips from some famous films. And all you need to do is to write down the names of those films. So you're going to see those clips. They'll come through in one go, one after another. There'll be a pause, and then we'll play them again. So make sure you have your sound on. And as I said, in a bit, we'll play them through. There'll be five clips, and they're all fair, some of them very famous films. And then we'll pause and we'll play them through again. Just trying this out, so hopefully it works. And if it does, we'll have it as more of a regular feature.
Hang on a minute, lads. I've got a great idea.
Olaf, you're melting.
Some people are worth melting for.
Now, just maybe not right this second.
Ladies and gentlemen, last shuttle leaving for the dock leaves in approximately 5 minutes. Drop what you're doing and leave now.
I'm also just a girl. Standing in front of a boy. Asking you to love her.
So, as I said, we'll have a brief pause and then I'll play those again. So, hopefully you got most of them, as I said, and hopefully that worked. But, yeah, give it a few seconds and we'll play them again. So, get your pens at the ready. They'll be coming up shortly.
Somebody's closer!
Hang on a minute, lads. I've got a great idea.
Olaf, you're melting.
Some people are worth melting for.
Now, just maybe not right this second.
Ladies and gentlemen, last shuttle leaving for the dock leaves in approximately 5 minutes. Drop what you're doing and leave now.
I'm also just a girl. Standing in front of a boy, asking him to love her.
We'll be taking a break there. I'll come back in about 5 or so minutes and give you the answers to the first half, and then we'll crack on with the second half. Looks as though the film clip round worked, so we'll be having more of that in the future. Charlie, as I said, what we'll be doing is posting the questions to rounds one and two in the chat shortly, so hopefully you'll see them all there. And if you do have any issues or further questions, let me know and post it in the chat and I'll pick it up during halftime. But thanks for tuning in, everyone. See you shortly. Right, just caught me there, just trying to finish off some snacks. How very unprofessional. Right, here are some answers for you. So, round one, current affairs. What did UK lorry drivers have confiscated from their lunchboxes at the Dutch border? It was their ham sandwiches, as you couldn't take meat or dairy products across the border. Two, which British model has been appointed as Kenya's tourism ambassador? It's Naomi Campbell. Three, the reality TV star who made an appearance for Crawley Town in their win against Leeds was Mark Wright. Four, what is the name of the ITV drama series centering around Steve Wilkins, who reopened two double murders, unsolved double murders from the 80s? It's the Pembrokeshire Murders. And easy one for question five, which building was stormed by a crowd on the 6th of January 2021? Is of course the Capitol. Round two is MA. And as I said, all the answers feature the letters MA in that order. So question one, from which ore is iron obtained? It's hematite. Hematite. Two, how are members of the Grand Lodge of All England more commonly known? It's the Freemasons. Answer one was ham sandwiches. So answer two to round two is the Freemasons. Three, the name of the boxer beat by Ali in the Rumble in the Jungle was George Foreman, now making a living selling very good grills. Four, the song Up There Where We Belong was a theme from An Officer and a Gentleman. So the answer was An Officer and a Gentleman. And finally, five, which cartoonist was the creator of the TV series The Simpsons? It's Matt Groening. Round three, food and drink. It's known as Bubble and Squeak in the UK, but what is it known as in Ireland? It's Colcannon. Two, what sea is a South American dish of marinated raw fish? It's ceviche. So the answer is ceviche. Three, which best describes chicken Maryland? Is it A, chicken served with sweet maple syrup? B, chicken in a warm fruit cocktail? Or C, fried chicken served chilled? It's C, fried chicken served chilled. Four, Lincolnshire sausages are flavoured with which herb? It's sage. And finally, where would you find the winemaking region of Yarra Valley? It's in Australia. Round four, movie clips. The movies were, one was Happy Gilmore, two was The Italian Job, three was Frozen, four was Jurassic Park, and five was Notting Hill. So hopefully you've got all those answers, but if you haven't, let me know, and I'll just take a brief pause, and then we'll go on to the second half. In case anyone's interested in football, the score is 1-1. So I'll just let you know what we've got coming up. So back to normal format. So round five is connections. Round six is Trump or Lil Wayne. Seven is the Wipeout. And eight is, of course, the music round. So round five is connections. So what you're going to get is four general knowledge questions. And so you just, they're general knowledge questions, there's 1 point available for each answer. But question five is, what is the link between the four previous answers? And you get 6 points for that. So as I said, four general knowledge questions, 1 point each, and 6 points for the connection. So question one, which pioneering pilot flew in the Spirit of St. Louis? Which pioneering pilot flew in the Spirit of St. Louis? Two, which Jersey-born actor first played Superman in 2013? Which Jersey-born actor first played Superman in 2013? That's Jersey as in the island off the coast, rather than Jersey, the town in near New York. Three, which cult 2004 American comedy starring John Heder in the role of the title character who befriends a new student who emigrated from Mexico and assists him with the cast presidential campaign? So I want to know the name of that movie. So it's a 2004 American comedy starring John Heder in the role of the title character who befriends a new student who emigrated from Mexico and assists him with his presidential campaign. Class presidential campaign. Four, which member of the royal family was born on the 23rd of April 2018? Which member of the royal family was born on the 23rd of April 2018? Five, what is the connection between those answers? So I'll pause a moment if you need any of those four questions repeated. Question four was, which member of the royal family was born on the 23rd of April 2018? So what is the name of the member of the royal family that was born on the 23rd of April 2018? So round six is Trump or Lil Wayne. Those of you who don't know, Lil Wayne is a rapper who was charged with possession of a loaded gun on a private plane, along with possession of a variety of narcotics, who's been pardoned by Trump in his, I think, about 70-odd or 80-odd pardons that he issued yesterday. So what I'm going to give you are five quotes, and all I want you to do, so it's 50-50, all you need to do is let me know is, did Trump say it or did Lil Wayne say it? So, quote one, I'm wanted by every lady cop. I'm wanted by every lady cop. Two, I am a member of the Lucky Sperm Club. I am a member of the Lucky Sperm Club. Three, I got court dates every month. It's me against the world. I got court dates every month. It's me against the world. Sorry, losers and haters, but my IQ is one of the highest. Sorry, losers and haters, but my IQ is one of the highest. And finally, 5. I've got 10 bathrooms. I could crap all day. I've got 10 bathrooms. I could crap all day. Right. So, as I said, all you had to do was work out if it was Lil Wayne or Trump that said those quotes. If you need any of those repeated, let me know. Hopefully that's the last we'll see of Trump in this quiz for some time. But for some reason, I think he'll be popping up quite regularly in the news. Okay, I don't think anyone needed anything repeated. So we'll go on to round 7, which is, as usual, Wipeout. Now, you know the drill. You get 1 point for each correct answer. But you don't have to answer all the questions. So say you chose to answer 3, you got 3 right, you get 3 points. But if you only get 2 right, you get 0 points because you've got 1 wrong. So any 1 wrong answer wipes out your points for the entire round. So question 1, one that's close to my heart. Which island, famous for its malt whiskey, is home to Lagavulin and Laphroaig? Which island, famous for its malt whiskey, is home to Lagavulin and Laphroaig? So that question once more. Which island, famous for its malt whiskey, is home to Lagavulin and Laphroaig? 2. Who composed the operas Tosca, La Bohème, and Madame Butterfly? Who composed the operas Tosca, La Bohème, and Madame Butterfly? Three. Which creatures in Greek mythology had the wings and claws of birds and the heads of women? Which creatures in Greek mythology had the wings and claws of birds, but the heads of women? 4. Maybe one for those of you who've been struggling with homeschoolings. God bless you all. Which planet in our solar system is 7th in distance from the sun? Which planet in the solar system is 7th in distance from the sun? And a slightly easier one to finish if you know your sport. Which animal is the nickname of the Argentinian rugby union team? Which animal is the nickname of the Argentinian rugby union team?
Let's correct you there. That isn't a planet anymore. But just say. Before they do.
Yeah. Well, the giveaway, as I've been corrected, is that it's not a planet anymore. And that is correct. It was declassified recently. So you can have that as a freebie question. That would basically led you to the answer there. So, right. Let me know if you need any of those repeated. Otherwise, we'll go into what's probably most people's favourite round, which is the music round. As usual, we're going to have 10 songs. You're going to hear those the intros to the 10 songs through once. You'll get 1 point for the song and 1 point for the artist. I'll run through them once. We'll have a pause and I'll play them again. I think we've got over our technical difficulties, so you're only going to hear them twice. And that will be your lot. So there's 20 points to play for. So without further ado, let's crack on with the music round. He says that there's no technical difficulties. Let's just check. Song one. There are technical difficulties. Give me a moment. Right. Hopefully this works now. Song two. It's a classic. Song three. Song. Bonus point for this, in the video to this song there's a very famous actress in the crowd who is in the crowd. Bonus point, name that actress. Next one. Next. Next one. And finally, so we'll have a pause and then we'll go from the start again. Matt, on question four, I'm just going to give you all a point because otherwise I'll just have a lot of controversy. So everyone, award yourselves a point for question four, because rather than risk wiping out or sort of heckling me afterwards. But I'll give, as I said, there would cause controversy. So just award yourselves a point. And I'll remember not to rush and fact check my quiz in future. Right, we're going to have those songs once again. So, song one. Song two. Happening there, so there seems to be some sort of reverb. I think that might be my equipment, but let me just check. Right, sorry about that. I'll start again. So this is starting from one. That's better. Song two. Jane, I'll leave you and Tom to argue that on the chat. So going on to song three. Song four. Seven. Eight. And finally, 10. And that's it. They're your songs. Right. We'll be back with the answers in about 5 minutes. So if you need anything repeated, let me know. Jane, now we can. I can still virtually deduct points and never play an S Club song. I was going to if I knew you were taking part today, but I may have to retract that. Anyway, I'll see you all in 5 minutes or so. Hello, welcome back. I'm just looking at the comments, I can't see them during the break. Welcome back. Here we go with some answers to the second half. So, round five was connections. Which pioneering pilot flew the Spirit of St. Louis? It was Charles Lindbergh. Two, which Jersey-born actor first played Superman in 2013? It was Henry Cavill. The name of the 2004 American comedy starring John Heder and his mate Pedro is Napoleon Dynamite. Which member of the royal family was born on the 23rd of April 2018? It was Prince Louis. The connection is they're all French leaders. Or the connection is French leaders. Now, round six is, did Trump or Lil Wayne say it? And you'll have a little picture of Lil Wayne coming up for those of you who don't know what he looks like. One, I'm wanted by every lady cop. Was that Trump or Lil Wayne? That was Lil Wayne. Two, I'm a member of the Lucky Sperm Club. That was our old friend Donald. Donald Trump said that. Three, I got court dates every month. It's me against the world. Sounds like something Trump would say, but it's actually Lil Wayne. Four, sorry losers and haters, but my IQ is one of the highest. That was Trump. And five, I've got 10 bathrooms. I could crap all day, was actually said by Lil Wayne, but could easily been said by Trump. I mean, that's what's so surprising. All of these, when I first saw them, I did quite badly at this quiz myself. Seven is the wipeout round. As I said, you've all got you've got a point already on this. So, first one though is which island is famous for malt whiskey? Is home to Lagavulin and Laphroaig, which are two very famous whiskies, and it's also sort of the name of the style of whiskey. It's Isla, I-S-L-A. Matt, just in case you're interested, I have switched on to something harder. Got some of this today. First time I ever had it. Not bad, very easy drinking. Not an Isla. Two, who composed the operas Tosca, La Boheme, and Madame Butterfly? Three, I got court dates every month. It's me against the world. It was Lil Wayne. Two, who composed the operas Tosca, La Boheme, and Madame Butterfly? It was Puccini. Three, which creatures in Greek mythology had wings and claws of birds but the heads of women? It was harpies. And four, which everyone got a buy for, which planet in our solar system is seventh in distance from the sun? It's Uranus. And which animal is the nickname of the Argentinian rugby union team? It's puma. Right, round eight, music. Hopefully we don't get reverb again. Right, song one. I'll let that play. I'll turn it down a bit. That is 7 Days by Craig David. Two is Black Betty by Ram Jam. Three, this is SOS by ABBA. This one is Dancing in the Dark by Bruce Springsteen, and a very young Courtney Cox appears as a girl in the crowd. Next, we have Madness, House of Fun. This one. Next. Dancing the Night Away by the Mavericks. Eight, this is Bad Guy by Billie Eilish. Nine, Stand By Me by Ben E. King. And finally, classic Swedish band, Roxette, It Must Have Been Love. And that's your lot for this week. Hopefully you enjoyed that. Hopefully it wasn't too hard or too easy, and pitched just right, just like the pudding from the famous nursery story. Anyway, as always, drop me a line if there's any particular round you'd like to see. Good to see so many of you online again, and hopefully not much longer of this. There's talk of probably March maybe, so only another month and a half of me to endure online. But as I said, really nice to see you. Stay safe and stay well, and I'll see you on here at 8 p.m. next Wednesday. See you soon.